Let's have a look at a slightly more realistic example. Here I have a two-dimensional car and a two-dimensional coordinate frame. I've labeled this coordinate frame W, and that stands for the world coordinate frame. And this is quite a common thing in robotics, to have one reference frame that all other reference frames are described with respect to. And to indicate that very, very clearly, I've labeled the X and Y axes with the subscript W. So it's very, very clear that this is the X axis of the W frame and the Y axis of the W frame. Now let's indicate some points of interest in this car. The left seat, the right seat, one of the mirrors, the door handles, and perhaps where we refuel it. I can describe each of these points by a vector with respect to the world coordinate frame. Now let's imagine that our car has moved. Now it's over here. I could now describe all of these points again in terms of vectors with respect to the origin of the world coordinate frame. But it's a little bit tedious because the points haven't actually moved with respect to the car. The whole car has moved, and now I have to redefine all the vectors again. Perhaps there's a better way. And there is. We're going to use the coordinate frame idea again, and we're going to create a new coordinate frame, and I'm going to attach it to the car. I label this frame C, C for car, and just to be clear, I label the axes XC and YC. The X and Y axes are the coordinate frame that are attached to the car. Now it's a simple matter to describe all of these points of interest on the car in terms of vectors with respect to the car's coordinate frame. Now if I move the car, these vectors have changed with respect to the world, but they haven't changed with respect to the car's coordinate frame. Let's simplify things a bit and introduce a pose here. So we've introduced another one of these fat arrows which represents a pose, and this is the pose from the world coordinate frame to the car's coordinate frame. So it's W, Xi, C. Now let's look at just a single point, one of the points on the door of the car. I'm going to label that point D. And we create a vector from frame C to this point D, and we denote that in the way we've already discussed. We use the symbol P to denote that we're talking about a vector. C is the reference frame, so this is a vector with respect to frame C. So it begins at the origin of frame C and it goes to the point D. Now let's consider that I want to know what is this vector, the point D, with respect to the world coordinate frame. In some sort of simplistic way, what I want to do is to add these two arrows. I want to move along here, and then I want to move along here. But it's not quite that simple. We can't add a pose and a vector. We can't add a fat arrow to a thin arrow. Poses and vectors are different mathematical objects, so we need to do this a little bit carefully. The way we do it is to introduce a new operator, and it's the dot. In this formalism, we have a pose, and it operates on a vector in order to transform it to a different coordinate frame. That's what this operator dot does. It transforms this vector, which describes the point D with respect to the coordinate frame C, to a vector that describes the point D with respect to the coordinate frame W. It performs a transformation between coordinate frames. All of this is rather abstract. Introduced this operator dot, but I haven't told you actually what it is. How would you code it? And we've introduced this abstract pose thing, described by the Greek letter psi, and I haven't said exactly what that is or how you could code that or implement that. And these are things we'll get to in the following sections in this lecture.